So the next point that we are going to study is mean free path. So in case of gases, we have studied that the molecules in the gases are in random motion. So during this random motion, they collide with each other as well as they collide with the walls of a container. During collision, there is no loss of energy, but the direction of their motion may get changed. So here we will understand what is the meaning of mean free path of the gaseous molecules. Suppose this is any container. In this container, there are gas molecules. So, this container consists of gas molecules. This is a stop action photograph. And suppose that we will consider the motion of single particle. Like this. Suppose this is a motion of a single particle or molecule inside a gas, and these are the molecules inside a gas which is in a container. Now here if we see that all the molecules are in random motion, they collide with each other and collide with the walls of container. Here we can say that the distance traveled by a particle during successive collision is called free path of the molecule. And here we have to consider mean free path. So mean free path means the average distance traveled by a molecule between two successive collisions is called mean free path. This mean free path is given by the lambda, and lambda equal to 1 upon root 2 pi d square n upon v. So this is the formula for mean free path, lambda. So here if we consider that this is a under root 2, square root 2, it is a constant, pi it is also a constant, then d is nothing but it is the size of a particle or molecule, n is number of molecules and v is the volume. So here if we can say n and v are also a constant value, so the mean free path is inversely proportional to the size of particle, that is d. It means that if size of particle is small, then there is a less chance of collision and the mean free path is larger. These two are inversely proportional to each other. Now unit of this lambda is meter. It is a average distance, so unit is meter. So the objective or MCQ question may be asked on this point. Lambda is directly proportional to d, inversely proportional to d, like that. Or question may be asked that if the size of particle is less, what will be the mean free path, lambda? So, if size of particle is less, there is a less chance of collision and mean free path lambda is more or larger. So, this is about the mean free path. Then the next point that we are going to study is pressure of ideal gas. So to understand about the pressure of ideal gas, we can consider a cubical box. So we can consider here a cubical box which consists of a ideal gas enclosed here. So in this ideal gas there are number of particles or molecules. These molecules are in a constant motion. They collide with each other and with the walls of this cubical box. So there is momentum for that particles or molecules. This momentum is imparted on the vessel or wall of this box. Due to this, there is a pressure exerted on these walls of a cubical box. So this pressure is given by the formula P equal to 1 upon 3 N upon V MV square bar. So by using this formula we can find out the pressure of ideal gas. So here N is nothing but the number of molecules of that gas. V is the volume of cubical box. M is the mass of gas. And V square bar is nothing but it is the average velocity of the particle inside this cubical box. So this relation gives us the relation between pressure of ideal gas and molecular speed V square bar. So if these quantities are constant, we can say that the pressure of ideal gas is directly proportional to the square of molecular speed. If molecular speed is more, the pressure exerted by gas molecules is also more. If molecular speed is very less, then the pressure exerted is also less. So these are related with each other. So this is about the pressure of ideal gas. So the next point is root mean square RMS speed of a gas molecules. So this root mean square speed is given by under root V square bar, which is equal to V RMS, that is root mean square speed, and it is equal to under root 3RT upon M0, where M0 is called molar mass and M0 is given by Na into M, and this Na is Avogadro number. Now this root mean square speed gives us the speed of gas molecules, that is RMS speed of gas molecules. So here also R is nothing but universal gas constant which has a constant value. M0 is the molar mass for that gas. So the RMS speed of a gas molecule is directly proportional to the square root of absolute temperature. So by using this formula, we can find out the root mean square speed of a gas molecule. Now this VRMS is a speed, so it has a unit meter per second. Now if we consider a nitrogen gas, so if nitrogen gas is at 300 Kelvin, then the RMS speed of nitrogen gas is 517 meter per second. So this is about the root mean square speed of a gas. Then the next point that we are going to study is interpretation of energy, interpretation of temperature in kinetic theory. So next point is interpretation of temperature in kinetic theory. So we have to interpret the temperature in case of kinetic theory. So this equation is E by N is equal to 3 upon 2 KB into T. So here E is nothing but it is the kinetic energy, N is nothing but number of molecules, KB is the Boltzmann constant and T is the temperature of gas. So in case of ideal gas, the molecules are non-interacting. So there is no any potential energy term. So only kinetic energy for gas molecules in case of ideal gas. So this E by N is equal to 3 by 2 KBT. Here is also 3 by 2 KB is constant. So we can say that the energy per unit number of molecules is proportional to the temperature. So this expression relates the macroscopic proper particles, that means temperature, to the kinetic energy, that is microscopic properties of gases. So this is a macroscopic parameter. It is related with microscopic parameter, and this is the base of kinetic theory of gases, the relation between temperature and kinetic energy. Then the next point that we are going to study is law of equipartition of energy. So now in case of law of equipartition of energy, the kinetic energy of gas molecules is given by kinetic energy is equal to 1 upon 2 mvx square plus one upon 2 mvy square plus 1 upon 2 mvz square. Now the average kinetic energy is given by this is the average kinetic energy. It is equal to average of 1 upon 2 mvx square plus 1 upon 2 mvy square plus average of 1 upon 2m vz square. Now the average kinetic energy per molecule is given by 3 upon 2 kbt. Average kinetic energy per molecule. So here we can say that therefore average of 1 upon 2 mvx square is equal to average of 1 upon 2 mvy square, and which is equal to average of 1 upon 2 mvz square, and it is equal to 1 upon 2 kbt. So from this, there is a law of equipartition of energy. It states that for a gas, the average kinetic energy per molecule is 3 by 2 kbt, and the each quadratic term is equal to the 1 upon 2 kbt. This is about the law of equipartition of energy. Then the next point that we are going to study is degrees of freedom.